Amandla Stenberg, the recipient of this year's Youth Innovator Award, is not only your favorite teen action character in The Hunger Games, or the star of the recent film about police brutality and the pressure of living between two worlds, The Hate U Give. She is an activist and a leader for our generation. At the age of 12, she delivered a speech with Cicely Tyson at the 2011 dedication ceremony of the Martin Luther King Memorial. Just a few years later, Time magazine crowned her one of the 30 most influential teens in the country. Oprah Winfrey then invited Amandla to speak at Oprah's Super Soul Sessions at UCLA. Oprah, the queen. Pretty big deal. Now, on top of that, she was also named Feminist Celebrity of the Year by Miss Foundation for Women. But in my mind, most importantly, Amandla co-starred in Beyoncé's Lemonade. You can't beat that, people. You just can't. Now, in Zulu, Amandla means power. And power is just what she is rapidly gaining as she makes an impact, blazing a trail for others. She has become a staunch supporter of the Time's Up organization, helping to spearhead the movement to make 50% of crew members women and minorities in 2020. She has even taken it upon herself to turn down projects that don't meet these principles. Now, just a few months ago, while Christine Blasey Ford powerfully testified at the Senate Judiciary Committee, Amandla bravely shared her own Me Too story. As a survivor of sexual assault, Amandla has become an advocate for other survivors across all identities. Amandla has an incredible following on social media, over 2 million followers. Okay, applause to that. I'm one of them. And she has used her platform to explore her sexual orientation and gender identity. In an interview with Wonderland, Amandla said, "I'm grateful for how being gay has afforded me this ability to experience and understand love and sex, and therefore life, in an expansive and infinite way." This beautiful, hopeful vision has made Amandla, who is out and proud and candid, a shining light for LGBTQ youth and people of all ages to hold on to. For Amandla is not just a film star or a fabulous Lemonade cameo, she is a hero. Now, to quote her own movie, "Don't ever let nobody make you quiet. God knows, Amandla never has and never will." I salute Amandla for making the world a better place, and in particular for her support in the LGBTQIA+ community. I am proud, on behalf of the Trevor Project, to present Amandla Stenberg with the 2018 Youth Innovator Award.
Okay, thank you to Josie for being here, first of all. She looking like a holiday snack tonight. She looks amazing. thank you to her for taking the time to write such lovely words about me and for continuously inspiring me to be fiercer and more fearless by being her beautiful self inside and out and stunting on all of us on the daily. So congrats on Josie to being her. Yeah, yes. it is so exciting to witness so many of my queer peers shine and grow and grow and grow. I first of all want to thank the Trevor Project for having me, for honoring me, and for bringing me into this space. It's just such a joyous relief to be in this room and celebrate just how divine it is to be queer. I have the utmost respect and gratitude for the work that the Trevor Project does, and it means so much to me and so many others, so thank you. I have to be honest, it feels a little strange to me to be honored in this way when I feel like I have yet to do the work that I want to do in celebrating queer identity. Although I've been out as queer since I was 15, I didn't come out as gay until about 6 months ago. Thank you. Appreciate it. So I still consider myself a baby gay. And I'm just now stepping into my unadulterated and uncompromised truth. And I'm being patient with my own process, which is different for everyone and is all things nerve-wracking and explosively beautiful, exciting and relieving, and sometimes just straight up uncomfortable and terrifying. But I am so grateful to have always been loved through it, to always be surrounded by friends and family who support the expression of my authenticity, and to be immediately accepted with open arms into a vibrant and beautiful community that I am so honored to call my own. And you all look beautiful tonight. It can definitely be daunting to be vulnerable in matters of personal identity when you're navigating it in a public manner. And I am really thankful for the recognition of that challenge, but I also know that there are so many others who do not have that support and receive no recognition because they haven't been afforded a public platform. So I dedicate this award to all of those people, and I dedicate it to all of you in this room. I never would have felt comfortable being me had I not seen the bright and brilliant way that all of you do you. So thank you. Oftentimes the way that we express ourselves or who we are is postulated in the context of pain and shame and tragedy. And although that might be a facet of our experiences, it is by no means the totality of who we are or how I experience being gay. And I find that understanding so limiting and inaccurate when I know that, if anything, we are the exact opposite of that. We are joy and we are light. And we are the sacred... Oh, thank you. I feel like we are the sacred unraveling of very damaging fabrications, and we reveal the power of truth through love. We are so unapologetic, and we are expressions of divinity and exuberance. So I am so grateful that I was given this gift. I am so exhilarated to continue exploring it, to continue learning about us and our history, to continue living and loving, and to strive for the celebration of us in all of the spaces and ways that we deserve to be celebrated. So thank you so much. Cheers. Have a good night. Turn up. God bless you.